Hey there, my name is Patrick Evans Hilton. We are here with another cuisine scene, and I am with George Stepanovich, and we are at the Bagel Bakery. How are you doing, George?
Well, very well. Yourself, Patrick?
Ah, very good. Now, you have a special anniversary here coming up.
Yes, we had 5 years. We're in our sixth year now already at the Bagel Bakery, and time is flying, I'll tell you that. Felt like we just opened not too long ago, and 6 years already.
It does go by fast. I remember coming in and trying some of your great sandwiches just shortly after you opened, too. Absolutely. Now, tell me, what is the appeal for bagels with folks? There's a lot of breads out there, biscuits, toast. What about bagels?
Bagels down here, bagels are made fresh every single day, unless you're getting a Lender's bagel from the grocery store. But a lot of people are more in tune to what they're eating. They like fresh made. House-made products nowadays more than store-bought. Our bagels are preservative-free. They're baked in this oven that's an original 1950 oven. We do it the old-school way with kettle boiling, so the quality is there. I mean, we're saving you a lot of time and effort and money going to New York getting bagels, where you can just get the good stuff right here.
Absolutely.
So bagels, I mean, you could put anything with it. Obviously, cream cheese, breakfast sandwiches, lunch sandwiches. It's like having any kind of option you want for a topping, because you have everything: seeds, coffee, sesame, onion, plain. The flavors are kind of endless.
And then y'all do different sandwiches here too, breakfast
we
and
do.
Lunch and
we
all.
We do. Well, we should have about a dozen flavors of cream cheese that we make all house and cream cheese. It starts with a Philadelphia base, which is the best. Then we add all our mixes to make our house cream cheeses. Then we have tons of breakfast sandwiches, fried eggs, which, you know, we have a hot grill.
Yeah, I was taking a look at that over there.
That all the sandwiches come off the grill, fresh shelled eggs, fresh bacon, over 120 to 150 pounds of bacon a week that we go through.
Wow.
Our house Italian sausage that we use for the patties. So we have about another dozen breakfast sandwiches, and then the lunch sandwiches are big deli sandwiches. Chicken salad, you know, turkey, ham, egg salad, tuna salad, all that stuff. Just like a New York deli.
Mm-hmm.
So we're very proud of the product that we put out. And I have a motto that if I'm not going to eat it, it's not good enough for me, it's not good enough for anybody. So
yeah. Now, we were in the back, and you were showing me how you mix up the dough, roll the dough out, and it comes out into those beautiful bagel shapes, and then the walk-in where the bagels take time to slowly rise.
Yes.
And then, so what do we got behind you here?
So this is the baking process. This is what makes a New York bagel a New York bagel.
Yeah.
And this is the kettle. And what we do is we take the proofed bagels and we slide them into the hot kettle.
And that's just hot water?
Yes, hot boiling water. And what that's going to do is that's going to start cooking the outside. Where in New York, the bagels, you get that sheen and that little firmness on the outside.
Yes.
That is because of this right here.
Okay.
So we just go ahead and give these a bath, what we call giving them a bath. And then make sure that they're in there for about, depending on how proof they are, it could be 30 seconds to a minute. Enough where you know that outside has got enough heat where it's going to hold its form. And then what we have here is we have saturated redwood burlap boards.
Okay.
And the bagel is going to rest on these when they go into the oven. So we can first bake the bottom and then we'll be able to bake the top, and I'll show you how we do that.
Now, how did you learn to make bagels?
Well, I learned to make bagels. A very good friend of mine started a bagel business about 20 years ago. And I was very fond of the old bakeries, with my dad going in the morning, Sunday after church, picking up a couple fresh loaves. And nothing to me tastes better than hot bread out of the oven.
Yeah.
And bagels, you could put anything on them. It was just the best comfort food that, you know, I knew of as a kid. So I asked a friend of mine to show me how to do bagels. And next thing you know, we had this whole operation, machine of an operation going. And it takes a lot of work. All your bakers will know that baking is just half science and half, just hard work. Nothing that is ever going to be exactly the same, especially with the weather here in Virginia Beach. With the humidity, one day it's more humid than the others. So you have to constantly be paying attention to your recipes and how the bagels are proofing, and sometimes they need a little more love than usual, but it keeps you on your toes. Absolutely.
And you're right. I don't think that folks really know how, even with things being more mechanized these days, how really labor intensive it is to make a bagel.
Yeah, it's we're a 7-day operation, and anytime you miss a day here due to a weather, inclement weather, or we're closed for a holiday, it's really hard to get up and going again because the machine is just continuously running.
Mm-hmm.
So what we do is these bagels, you see, they were sitting on cornmeal on that board.
Okay.
So you have a bit of a cornmeal bottom here.
Mm-hmm.
So what we're going to do, and that, so it doesn't stick to the stone. So we're going to line them up on the boards here with the belly up, because we're going to go in with the belly up so the heat bakes the bottom enough so it gets a little bit of a crust. So when you flip it, it won't stick to the hot stone.
All right.
I'm gonna make these just plain bagels.
Okay. Now, how long will it take for them to cook?
Well, they're gonna go belly up around for about 4 minutes. Each rotation is just a little over 2 minutes.
Okay.
And then we're gonna flip them. And then they'll be in about another 18 to 20 minutes.
Okay.
And then you're done. So, you know, when people come here, sometimes, depending on rushes, you know, you could have, you know, dozens of plain bagels, and then next thing you know, people buying them by the dozens, you know, you have to wait for them to come out. We start baking every day at 4 o'clock in the morning, and, on Saturdays and Sundays, especially, we don't stop baking until noon. So we're constantly baking from 4 o'clock till 12 o'clock in the afternoon. So here they go now. And then they're on shelf 4.
Yeah.
And we'll pay attention. And I think we have some other ones coming out here in a minute.
All right. Well, very good. Well, George, I sure do appreciate your time. And well, these look awfully good over here. Do you have a favorite?
I'm partial to the everything bagel.
Oh yeah.
I think most everyone is. That's the most popular bagel. Everything
sure.
In plain, cinnamon raisin. But you know, with being around 6 years now, we have a lot of traditionalists, a lot of New Yorkers coming back to us, and they eat a lot of onion, the poppy, sesame seeds. I mean, they're all pretty spectacular, I think.
And they all look very good. Well, George, I sure do appreciate it very much. Thank you.